Dick White, the choice of the England team, with the red stripe down the trousers, and plenty of flags for St George to be carried. Finally carried in football now. The World Cup has changed that. So often it was the Union flag that was carried and not the flag of St George, because always at the Commonwealth Games.
Ladies and gentlemen, these are the finest athletes of the Commonwealth. The most talented sports men and women of 72 nations who have trained so hard and for so long to compete over the next 10 days. So let's hear you shout for the athletes of the 17th Commonwealth Games!
Crowd doing their job with flashing their torches. But we seem to have a few problems with the fireworks. At last they come.
Ladies and gentlemen, to sing the salute to the athletes, please welcome Russell Watson.
Accompanied by the Manchester Gospel Choir.
It's been a long road, getting from there to here. It's been a long time, but my time is finally near. And I can feel a change in the wind right now. Nothing's in my way, and I'm not gonna hold me down no more. No, the night.
Soul. No one's gonna bend or break me. I can read.
27-year-old with a happy knack of mixing both the classical and the popular.
Ladies and gentlemen, we will now raise the ceremonial flag of the Commonwealth Games Federation.
The music of the Battle of Britain suite by William Walton. And the flag of the Commonwealth Games to be raised by the 1st Battalion of the King's Liverpool and Manchester Regiment. The Queen Mother was their Colonel-in-Chief.
In the spirit of fair play, and on behalf of all the athletes gathered here tonight, an oath will be taken by James Hickman.
We declare that we will take part in the Commonwealth Games 2002 in the spirit of true sportsmanship, recognising the rules which govern them, and desirous of participating in them for the honour of the Commonwealth and for the glory of sport.
James Hickman, 6 Commonwealth Games medals, gold in the 200 butterfly in Kuala Lumpur.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the chairman of the Commonwealth Games Federation, Michael Fennell.
Games, 7 years in planning. Much refurbishment after the terrorist bomb of 1996. The stadium a tribute to Manchester's endeavours and their fortitude.
Your Majesty, Your Royal Highnesses, distinguished guests, athletes of the Commonwealth, ladies and gentlemen, in a short while, the 17th Commonwealth Games will be declared open by Her Majesty the Queen, and thereafter, competition will commence in earnest in 17 sports, including events for athletes with disabilities. Over the next 10 days, we will see the finest athletes in the Commonwealth from 72 countries and territories competing for glory, not only in pursuit of medals, but also to achieve their best in the spirit of friendship. It is our hope that all competitors will exemplify all the qualities of fair play and the Commonwealth's shared values of integrity, tolerance, and respect. Over the past few years, the organizing committee has worked tirelessly in preparing for these games. We commend their efforts and the support they have received from the Manchester City Council, the British government, and a wide range of sponsors and supporters. They are now joined by thousands of wonderful volunteers whose contributions will be invaluable to the success of the Games. The Queen's Jubilee Baton, which has traveled through 31 countries in all six regions of the Commonwealth, covering approximately 60,000 miles, will shortly arrive. This baton carries a special message of Her Majesty to the athletes and people of the Commonwealth and has had an extraordinary reception everywhere it went. We are particularly pleased and honored that these Games coincide with the celebration of the Queen's Golden Jubilee as head of the Commonwealth. We therefore dedicate these Games to Her Majesty in recognition of her outstanding leadership over the past 50 years. In a few moments, the baton will arrive in the stadium, and I shall invite Her Majesty the Queen, as head of the Commonwealth, to receive the baton, read her message, and declare the 17th Commonwealth Games open. We wish everyone great success in these Games, and let it be a joyful celebration of the best of Commonwealth sport.
Being carried around the world of the Commonwealth, and since the 6th of June, 50 days around the United Kingdom, the Queen's Golden Jubilee Baton will come to us from the sky, made of machined aluminium, weighs 1.69 kilograms, 10 millimeters high, diameter of 42.5 millimeters to at its widest 85 millimeters. The message held in a capsule which is inserted into the top. Sensors detect the pulse rate of all who have carried it, the runner's heartbeat, the essence of human life. It's been there. Be seen by the many thousands and thousands who followed its course. Here, Sally Ledbetter, the winner of the Blue Peter competition, 15-year-old who knew how many countries there were in the Commonwealth.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the reigning Olympic and Commonwealth heptathlon champion, Denise Lewis.
Now with a daughter, born on April the 1st, Lauren. So this Commonwealth Games working for television rather than competing in her seven events. First carry it around the city of Manchester Stadium in a sedate style.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the youngest woman ever to sail the globe single-handed, Ellen MacArthur.
Ellen MacArthur, who plans another trip in Kingfisher 2 in January with a crew this time, attempting to break the record going round the world, the Jules Verne record. Kip Tanui, the first to break 8 minutes for the steeplechase, now a mentor and coach of Kenya's next generation of athletes.
In three Commonwealth Games, and one of the most successful swimmers of recent times, Susie O'Neill.
Susie O'Neill, now an ambassador for Australian support with the International Olympic Committee. Also the holder of a gold medal at the Commonwealth Games, he won the single sculls in 1986. First man to hold Olympic, world and world records at the same time. One in Atlanta in 96.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Manchester United and England captain, David Beckham.
Just a short journey for England's captain. Talk about all the week who it would be, but I think most people really knew. And there's an extra special reason, which has nothing to do with his football, but the efforts that he and his wife Victoria have made in the life of a young lady we're about to meet. Here she is, Kirsty Howard.
Than even the greatest sportsmen and women here tonight, a very special runner, Kirsty Howard.
6-year-old, her 45-pound oxygen tank being towed around, and she's done a fantastic job. She's raised over £1.5 million for the Francis House Manchester Children's Hospice of the Rainbow Family Trust. And Her Majesty comes down to meet the bravest little girl. your panel hands the Jubilee baton to the baton marshal, Lynn Walters, who will open it so that Her Majesty can read the speech and open these 17th Commonwealth Games in Manchester.
Athletes from over 70 nations and territories are gathered here in Manchester, a city with its own great sporting tradition. You come from the world over, Africa, the Americas, Asia, Australasia, Europe, all are represented tonight. This message, which left Buckingham Palace in the Jubilee baton on Commonwealth Day last March, has crossed every continent in its journey to this opening ceremony. The Jubilee baton relay symbolizes how the Commonwealth brings people together. All of us participating in this ceremony tonight, whether athletes or spectators, or those watching on television around the world, can share in the ideals of this unique association of nations. We can all draw inspiration from what the Commonwealth stands for: our diversity as a source of strength, our tradition of tolerance, requiring respect for others and a readiness to learn from them. Our focus on young people, for they are the future. These games, the friendly games, embody these values. I congratulate those who have organized this great occasion, and I look forward, along with millions around the world, to following 10 days of sporting excellence and athletic achievement. It is my pleasure in this, my golden jubilee year, to declare the 17th Commonwealth Games open.
Gentlemen, before the finale of our show, the athletes will now leave the stadium to prepare for the 10 days of sporting excellence to come. To accompany their departure, the 103rd Regiment of the Royal Artillery will fire a 21-gun salute. So please remain in your seats and show your appreciation, wishing them all the very best of luck for the final time this evening, the athletes of the 17th Commonwealth Games.
Troop Commander of the 103rd Regiment of the Royal Artillery, Captain Alistair Copley, 209 and 213 battery based in St Helens in Manchester. And among his troop, Sergeant Christine Gibbons and Bombardier Margaret Cooper. These are guns they received last September. They're firing at 10-second intervals. Leader Lieutenant Alistair Basley, 216 battery in Bolton, has to report ready before the order to fire is given. See their relationship with the stadium geographically. Five to fire.
Ladies and gentlemen, for the past 50 days, almost 5,000 runners throughout the UK have taken part in the Queen's Jubilee Baton Relay. Along the way, a group of young people have been giving them plenty of musical motivation. So please welcome, here to perform Ain't No Stopping Us Now, and from the heart of the North Stand, United Colours of Sound.
departure of the weapons of sound and the united colours of sound. Now a fantasy finale of the Spirit of Manchester will follow. We tried to tell the story of how Manchester came to be. We've simply shown what it is in the 21st century. City of rich culture, originally a Roman settlement, crucial in the Industrial Revolution, but they haven't tried to cram all that into one evening, thereby minimize history. Turned instead to the verve of Manchester 2002.
Ladies and gentlemen, this has been an evening full of extraordinary people. World-class sportsmen and women have gathered together under the flags of the Commonwealth nations. Tonight, singers, dancers, and musicians have shared their unique cultures and talents. But the athletes and the performers aren't the only stars tonight. This is a celebration of Manchester, the people, the city, and the spirit. Manchester, a city of ordinary people who, touched by the spirit of Manchester, do extraordinary things every day.
to overflowing, and a certain irony that at the end the rain should come. Extraordinary things from ordinary people. Truly marvellous conclusion, the music of Stravinsky. We can still do these things in this country. Manchester has just proved that.
We look forward to welcoming from Manchester here again in 10 days' time to the closing ceremony.
She makes her way out of the city of Manchester Stadium, and dare I suggest, like everyone else, she's been thoroughly entertained here by a slice of Manchester life, colourful and spectacular.